So today's video is a bit different. Today I just wanted to talk about some of the books I've been reading. There's no real reason for that, but I just wanted to. Well, actually, there is a bit of a reason, because it has something to do with translation, and so I thought it would be interesting to share it with you. I'm just talking about the books I've read more or less in the past month or so, because about a month ago is when I got Ilacci. So Ilacci is a book by Domenico Starnone. He's an Italian author. My two languages are Italian and English, by the way, so I'm going to read in both those languages. Now I'm in the States, so they're more English language books. But I was interested in this because this book, Ilacci, was translated into English, has recently been translated into English, and in fact, I think it's out now in English, by Giunta Lahiri. So Giunta Lahiri is actually, she's very interesting. She was born in London to Bengali parents and raised here in the States. Then she moved to Italy and really liked it there, learned Italian, and wrote a book in Italian, not as her first language. The name of this book is In Altre Parole. I haven't read it, I confess, but I've heard interviews with her, and she's quite interesting. This book by Domenico Starnone, called Ilacci, is a book that she has recently translated into English from Italian. And so I thought it would be interesting to read the Italian version and then read the English version and kind of compare them. By the way, brief side note, Domenico Starnone is interesting in his own right because, well, he had sort of a controversy surrounding him. Elena Ferrante, Neapolitan novels, that whole saga going on. Elena Ferrante is no one's real name. No one knows who really wrote them. But then someone came out with an article that it was actually this guy, Domenico Starnone, or his wife, I can't remember. Anyway, they found out it probably wasn't him. He's a personal friend of Giunta Lahiri, and I've never read any of his books before, so I thought it'd be interesting to read this in Italian and then read her translation in English, because I know she would have worked closely with him since they're personal friends as well. I've only read the Italian version. I don't have it with me because I loaned it to my sister. She can probably show you a picture since she's my editor. I'm going to find that interesting, I'm sure. The next book I read, since I came here to Charleston a bit less than a month ago, I decided that it was finally time to tackle this. Charleston. 400-something pages, 470 pages. But it's basically all about Charleston, the history of Charleston. Charleston is a very historical city. It actually is more than 100 years older than the country it's in. It's one of those, like Savannah, that wasn't destroyed during the Civil War, you know, even though it's in the South. So it retained a lot of that, the old world architecture and whatnot. It also has a Huguenot church, French Huguenot church, which I think there are only two of them in the world, one in the UK and the other one here in Charleston. That was a long book, but it was interesting. So if you're interested in Charleston for some reason, definitely look it up. Charleston. The next book I read was this one. I'm not sure why I read it. It wasn't that good. I don't know, maybe some of you liked it. I didn't like it much at all. Oh, actually, I do know why I read it. My sister gave it to me, and she's the editor of this, so I should be nice about it. I am quite interested in Taoism, and I did read quite a bit about it when I was in Taiwan and also China. And obviously, I read Winnie the Pooh when I was a kid. The author was trying to draw these two things together, and it was a very weak link. He was really trying to pick and choose how to tie certain aspects of Taoism to Winnie the Pooh and tie different other ways of thinking from Confucianism to Western whatever to this and that, to the other characters, Christopher Robin and Eeyore and whatnot. I mean, he was oversimplifying so many matters. I know very little about Taoism. You know, what little I've read is that as an armchair enthusiast, but even I could tell that. Anyway, if you're interested in Taoism, you can find better books than this. If you're not sure if you're interested in Taoism, then by all means read this, and if it gets you interested, then read another book about it. So I've also been reading, actually listening to, because I also use Audible, a bunch of mystery novels. My wife really likes mystery novels, so we listen to the same ones, so then we can talk about them. If you do like mystery novels, I do recommend Harlan Coben, because to me, I think they're the smartest type of these mystery novels. There are other very interesting ones that we've been listening to, some that take place in Amish country, another one that takes place in Alaska. What else? I read a short biography of this guy. I'm not sure why. He was sanctified recently. I know there's some controversy. He was one of the original, I think, the first Spanish priest to going to California, and he set up a bunch of the monasteries over there. Basically, you know, there are a lot of sands around there, and he set up a bunch of them, most of them. He wanted to set up a chain of them. So I thought it'd be interesting to read. It was very short and sweet, and yeah, pretty interesting. Anyway, the main reason I'm doing this is because I'm looking forward to reading The Language Instinct by Steven Pinker. I'm a big fan of his. I haven't read this yet. I probably should have, but I found it at a library sale for 75 cents. If anyone has read it, feel free to let me know what you think of it. But first, I'm going to finish reading this book, which I'm reading right now. I have no idea what this book is about or anything about it, but I just judged it purely based on its cover, so we'll see how it goes. And it's another one I got at that library sale. By the way, if you want cheap books, always go to your local library sale. You know, they usually have sales every now and then. You get books for very cheap. And that's pretty much it. The only other book that I'm reading right now is Start With Why by Simon Sinek. This is a business book, and I try to, you know, read business books since I'm in business. So that's the one I'm reading now. I don't know if it's any good or not. I do know I've read some articles by the author, and I've heard him speak before, and I do like what he has to say. So we'll see how the book is. So this is a bit of a change of pace, but I've been reading some interesting stuff lately, so I just wanted to share it. So that's pretty much it. I'll be back with more videos about freelance translation next time. So feel free to subscribe, and you'll get more videos that deal with freelance translation and languages and stuff right to your YouTube page. If you did like this video or found it interesting, please click like, because that always helps, or the thumbs up thing they have down there. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.